In case a repeated measures one way ANOVA in R turns out to be significant, it is of interest to the researcher between which of the measurements differences in regard to the dependent variable can be observed. To achieve this, pairwise comparisons are being done. Those are simply multiple paired t-tests. I'll use the pairwise underscore t underscore test function of the rstatix package in combination with pipes. I'll start with the data frame and add the pipes operator behind it. The next line is the pairwise underscore t underscore test function that has the dependent variable, followed by tilde, that small wave symbol, and the time variable. The paired equals true argument needs to be added since you have repeated aka paired measures. Finally, the p-adjust method argument is required to counter the alpha error inflation caused by multiple pairwise comparisons. The easiest and also most conservative one is Bonferroni, where your p-value will be multiplied with the number of pairwise comparisons being done. Other methods like Holm, FDR and so forth can be found in the documentation of the pairwise underscore t underscore test function and used accordingly, albeit your choice needs to be justified, at least with research field specific standards. Eventually, we get a table that shows all pairwise comparisons. In the last two columns, their respective adjusted p-values are shown as well as significance indicators on the 5% alpha level. In my example, I can observe a difference between t0 and t1 and t0 and t2. This indicates a working intervention, in my case, an exercise plan. There is also no further increase or an immediate bounce back since t1 and t2 show no difference worth mentioning. Please consult the paper, the ASA statement on p-values, and draw your own conclusions, dichotomizing decisions based solely on the p-value compared to the alpha level. Finally, you might have a significant repeated measures one-way ANOVA and no low enough p-value in post-hoc testing when controlling for alpha error inflation. That is not a contradiction, and the internet is full of discussions about this phenomenon on significant tests and non-significant post-hoc tests. Just keep in mind that a p-value to which it all boils down to is a function of sample size, which decreases with an increase in sample size for any effect size that is different from zero. So a non-significant test result in almost all cases tells you you're lacking statistical power as a result of too small of a sample. Don't, however, do post-hoc power analysis to justify your non-findings, because the observed power is a one-to-one function of the p-value. After doing post-hoc tests, you should calculate the effect sizes for observed differences, which is shown in the following video.